Well, we're still trying to reach Evans to see if he can give us updates, and there he is. So we're gonna go straight to him. He's getting ready, by the way. But Evans, good morning. Can you hear us?
Yes. Good morning.
How are you?
I can hear you.
How are you doing?
Well, I'm doing very well, and you?
I'm fine, thank you very much. Well, back to you. Especially concerning Obuasi and what's happening there. I know that citizens are asking for either a curfew or a shutdown. What exactly is the situation?
Yeah, absolutely. So they're looking at the astronomical increase of numbers as far as COVID-19 cases is concerned. It has come as a bigger worry to the residents over there. They are living in fear, I must tell you, and not only Obuasi, because if you're talking about proximity, then when Kumasi is also very close to Obuasi. I mean, they have this trading corridor, so a good number of people within the Kumasi Metro will normally move to Obuasi to transact business and come back, and then vice versa. So it's a worry. One would say a multifaceted worry, because people in Kumasi also fear that, considering the increasing number of cases within the Obuasi enclave, there's likely to be another spread because of possible contact and all of that. But for Obuasi, it's something that DISEC is considering. But one would say the power lies on the president as to whether he's going to evoke some level of law as far as the the restrictive law is concerned.
Okay.
Just to impose some level of curfew on Obuasi. But I can tell you that it is something that DISEC wants at the moment.
Now, of course, that's what they want, but like you said, it's up to the president and, of course, the health authorities to decide. But any update on the isolation center? Have residents, attempted to even go to that particular area again, you know, concerning the patients?
There hasn't been any new resistance, but the good news is that now KCCR is assisting Confinology Teaching Hospital to set up a lab that can process samples and then process samples for COVID-19. We do not know when that particular lab will be ready, but we are looking forward to the shortest possible time. If that happens, it will not only minimize the pressure on KCCR, but it will also ensure rapid delivery of results.
But one would ask, why has it taken so long? I mean, we'd expect that Okonfor-Anochi would have had a lab to test for COVID by now.
Well, it has. I mean, it's a question that we're all asking. But I think sometimes it has to do with the installments. I mean, the kind of facilities that has to be procured in order to set up this particular kind of lab. Because especially the biosafety level 3 laboratory, it has a lot of sophisticated equipment, and I'm not pretty sure whether Confinology had those equipment. You know, like the name of the virus, it's a novel. So one would say they never anticipated that a time will come we're going to have a situation like this on our hand. But at least it's better late than never. They are doing that, and I'm sure it will also help in one would say real time results.
Okay. Okay, now just a quick update on the issue in Obuasi, because yesterday when we spoke to the DC, she mentioned that this particular isolation center is a 13-bed capacity. And at the moment, they were only able to have 10 people occupy the place. But looking at the high rate of infection in Obuasi, there are still some other isolation centers. Can you update us on what exactly is happening with that? Is there a need for them to put up more isolation centers, or do they have enough?
Well, they do not. The one that they had was the AGA hospital. That is where they had actually...
Okay, we'll just hold on just a little bit to see if Evans could join us. I think he was probably trying to... Okay, he's back.
So now they will have to bank their hosts in private estate owners or private property owners, also reasoning with them or being, one would say, kind enough to release their properties for that effect. And they are getting in there because this particular property was willingly released by the private owner. Mm. And they are looking for to more people emulating that particular example. But I think what has to be done is to change their modus operandi, because already the stigma has become a major barricade to this particular progress, I mean, the progress that they are making. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to manage information in such a way that people will not have, one would say, first-hand information as to whether a particular property has been earmarked for an isolation center.
I mean, since the resistance, has there been any attempt to further educate the people, you know, on the need to also understand the severity of the virus and the need to also have isolation centers dotted across just so that they can be protected as well? Have you seen anything or heard any extra information on in terms of education?
Yes, and it is cutting across all spheres of the public life. Now, I can tell you that even the police is also on the ground educating people, because any resistance will mean that they will have to also do extra work, and they don't even have the numbers over there. Mm. If it becomes so critical, it means men will have to be deployed from Kumasi and other places to reinforce law and order there.
Okay.
So the education is going down. I know the commander, DSP Asenso, and his team are doing that just for people. They are not using force. They are using persuasive means for people to understand the need for them to accommodate and also stick to or adhere to safety protocols. So I think that is that one is also being done on the ground.
All right, thank you so much, Evans, and we'll get back to you later in the show for some more updates. That's Evans Inkum, our Ashanti regional correspondent, and he was updating us on the issue in Obuasi in the Ashanti region.